Well, he could use threats. He has a lot of leverage in certain areas, perhaps, or if not a lot, at least some leverage. He could use the migrant threat. Turkey is right now home to 3.5 million estimated Syrian refugees. He has been able to use that as a bargaining trip, as a trump card, so to speak, forgive the pun, vis-a-vis negotiations with Europe. So, you know, unleashing all of those refugees, a flood of refugees, as you might see it, threatening Europe with that. He could turn to allies, which he might see as more reliable than the United States, such as Russia, from whom Turkey recently purchased an anti-missile defense system, an S-400 anti-missile defense system. Turn to Putin. You could turn to China. China's been giving Turkey some loans. Even turn to Qatar, which has been sort of under siege itself from Saudi Arabia and other Arab neighbors. So Turkey could be seen as sort of an ally for economic ties with Qatar. And those ties have been strengthening. But then again, you have to weigh and balance things geopolitically. Get back to that question. If Qatar and Russia and China, for all of their animus right now, for various reasons, towards the U.S. and Donald Trump's U.S., if they have to weigh in balance the U.S. versus Turkey, at the end of the day, they may choose the U.S. because, unfortunately, might, as we often say, makes right in international markets and financial markets. So they might have no choice because, at the end of the day, Trump and Erdogan, they might have mighty egos. They might go at each other. But Erdogan's options are very limited if he thinks he's going to win an economic showdown with Donald Trump. At the end of the day, will he release this American pastor? Who knows? He has a giant ego and he's held out and he's been defiant in the past, but he's definitely under a lot of pressure. And my sense is that if he's going to go picking a war with Trump, he's possibly going to end up on the losing side and he might have to eat some humble pie.